This is the MX Vertical and it might be the most comfortable mouse I've ever used. Here is my full take after using it for a while. So the box here is already empty because I've been using the mouse, but what you get initially is the mouse itself, a unifying receiver, a USB-C cable for charging, and a few simple manuals. After installing the Logitech Options software and pairing the mouse with Bluetooth, we can see some additional settings. This mouse has four programmable buttons, so it has the thumb button, the middle click button, and the forward and backward buttons that can all be reprogrammed to do other things. In the Logitech Options software, you can change the DPI speed, so basically how sensitive the cursor of the mouse is. If you want to switch between normal and precision work. Of course, it can also be reprogrammed to do other things like media control. So by pressing the button, you can pause the music. By swiping up and down, you can change the volume. And by swiping left or right, you can skip the tracks. Another interesting use for this button is you can also use it as a highlight or a magnifying tool. This can be useful if you do, for example, tech tutorials. So when you hold down the button, it will make a highlight around your cursor so everyone can see what you're pointing at. Also, you can use it as a magnifying glass on the screen. So this could be useful for people with poor eyesight when needing to do some precise clicks on the screen. So pretty universal button there. Now let's talk about the main reason to buy this mouse, the shape. It has this weird looking shape that puts your hand into a handshake position. So it really takes pressure off your wrist and forearm. It's very comfortable to hold. And the curved design guides your fingers and palm into this natural position. That said, this mouse forces you to hold it with a full hand grip. So if you're used to claw or fingertip grips, this is going to feel a bit different. Now for the shape, it also has some downsides. For starters, the base is pretty narrow. So if you're moving quickly your hand across the desk, for example, for gaming or anything else that requires a lot of flicking motion, while it's very easy to tip the mouse so that the base won't be any more fully in contact with the table, as the mouse is not heavy or wide enough to really feel stable with the fast movements. That's not really an issue if you're doing basic office work, but as I said, if you're used to moving fast across large monitors or design software or gaming, well, this mouse doesn't really do it in terms of stability. Also, the thumb button, while it's useful, it's still a bit high, so it's kind of hard to reach. Also, I must note that during hot days, this kind of rubber coating can get a bit warm under your hands. I know the biggest issue for me, and that's the reason I won't be using this mouse in the future, is the scroll wheel. It's kind of loud and stiff, so if you want to use it in software with a lot of zooming in and out, like AutoCAD, Photoshop, or even just scrolling through long documents, this scroll wheel does slow down the workflow. So now for the final thoughts. Well, comfort-wise, this mouse is amazing. It really feels great in your hand. There is no wrist strain whatsoever. But now for productivity, it's kind of a mixed bag with the narrow base and the loud scroll wheel. So personally, I will be going back to a different mouse, so probably an MX Master. But if wrist pain is your main concern, the MX Vertical is also worth checking out. So I hope this video was useful to you. If that's the case, please leave a like and I will see you in the next one.